Bun găsit, vă spun tuturor, la interviul săptămânii de la Misiunea Verde. Astăzi l-am invitat pe Cari Herleni, director de program la SITRA, o autoritate care elaborează și implementează strategia finlandeză de economie circulară, să ne dezvăluie câteva din tainele succesului țării sale în materie de sustenabilitate. Welcome, Cari, and thank you very much for accepting our invitation.
Thank you very much. It's an honor to be in your show. Thank you.
I was amazed about what I discovered about your country. What is the great secret of Finland in developing such a culture of sustainability at all levels of the society?
That is a very difficult question indeed. I have been many times asked and many times I have some difficulties to answer exactly, because it's a secret sauce, so it is not like revealed even to the Finns. No, I'm just joking. I think one of the key things here is that Finland and Finnish citizens really value nature, and it's all over us here in Finland, so it's not like lost in many ways. It's very pure. And we have been like nominated as the greenest country in the world, for example, or we have been in a very high rankings in the clean tech indexes internationally. So I think those are part of the secret sauce. But I think it's not only about the environmental point of view, it's also about the valuation of appreciation of research and development and education, to name some. And also that there is a very strong support for governance type of issues, taking leadership in issues like circular economy, as what I've been leading here.
Yeah, this is something that everyone wants, basically. And you are a country of makers. Basically, in Finland, everyone, as you said, is has a role in to play in sustainability. How did you get there? Because I don't know, it's amazing to see how everyone has a role, small or big, but I think that this is the key. How did you get there?
Well, I would put there a couple of milestones from my point of view. In the last maybe 5-6 years, Finland has been very much focusing on circular economy, which is of course one of the important cornerstones for sustainability in a larger context. And in Finnish case, for example, this year we asked our citizens how do they see circular economy, and circular economy is an economic model really that is not wasting any resources. So we are not in circular economy producing more and more goods, but it's really the consumption is based on using services, sharing, renting and recycling, instead of owning, for example. And certainly materials are not destroyed in the end, but they are made for new products over and over again. So in that sense, I would argue that the understanding that we have to be very smart with the use of natural resources is one of the key things in the Finnish society. And that's also understood in the citizen level, that you have to be very good in recycling, for example, but also so that you buy products that last longer, for example, and you use more services rather than buying everything for your own house. So it's like getting to more like a service culture as well. So I think one of the key things has been that the circular economy is a strong part of the Finnish society. And secondly, I would say that our role as SITRA has been also important in kind of promoting these things. So it's been a kind of, let's say, very consistent and for some time already that we've been working in the space. But at the end of the day, I think it's about our citizens and how they value this kind of society.
Okay, tell us a little bit more about SITRA.
So basically, SITRA is an innovation, I would say, itself. So we were a gift from Finnish Parliament to 50-year-old Finland in 1967. So we have been around for some time, and Sitra is I would say think, do and connect tank for Finland. So very interesting organization under the Finnish Parliament. We are very independent. We are also called the Future House for Finland, and our mission is really to make sure that Finland is successful also in the future, and that the Finnish citizens and industries and the economy is obviously going to the same direction.
Okay, so Sitra is an authority who elaborate and implement national Finnish strategy on circular economy, but on the other hand, you are kind of investor also.
That's true that we also fund. We are not like a typical venture capital investor. We actually used to be a venture capitalist, but we were able to scale it up in Finland so that currently nowadays there's a very strong venture capital community in Finland. So in fact, we have not only funded, but we have also created a joint project with the Finnish stakeholders. There are a couple of examples I could mention here. One of them is related to the social part of circular economy. It's really that there is likely that some jobs will disappear and new jobs will emerge, and certainly a lot of jobs will change in content. And what in our opinion is very important is that workers' skills are updated and making sure that the fair transition is possible so that every professional can apply circular thinking in their work, regardless what they do. And for those reasons, we have been working very much in investing in teaching circular economy principles in formal education sector and in lifelong learning. And that's something that we have also recognized just recently, that we should put much more focus in vocational education.
What types of new jobs have you discovered on the vocational area?
For example, we have taken a construction sector and the need to kind of course, make sure that the building sector and the whole value chain gains more kind of understanding about circular economy and just to make sure that for example in practically in building sites all way from the kind of design phase to demolition, the circular economy principles are already taken into account. So that's a kind of a very necessity in order to make it sustainable. And for example, the courses will include different kind of visualizations to students and teachers, different videos and animations on promoting new skills in the field. And similarly, this will be done in the chemical industry and technology industries as well.
But everything is based on researcher, I think, and research and studies, because otherwise you can't see what is the future of jobs or industries or everything.
Absolutely. Science and research is key in all of these activities, and certainly in Finland, innovation and the investments in innovation in circular economy has been quite strong in recent years, in more generally as well.
You talk a lot about education in Finland. Romania takes the first steps in education for sustainability in the public education system. What can we learn from you, from Finland experience?
Well, I would say the first thing is that in circular economy, it is actually building on very good Finnish education system in generally. So there's very strong education system in Finland, and we are very happy to kind of rely on that. But certainly, of course, these kind of trends like circular economy it comes at certain point, and it's really needed that these new mega trends are integrated in the studies. And our advice is to look at the country's education system as a whole. For example, in Finland, we at Sitra, we funded 26 circular economy teaching projects in all education level, with an idea that we will create change agents of tomorrow, and making sure that circular economy is studied in all education levels, not as a separate silo topic, but so that it's integrated in arts, math, you know, different business, for example, material sciences, and making sure that we have only circular economy natives in the future. And as an example, for example, already from 2018, we have had like around 25,000 students and almost 2,000 teachers in these kind of courses.
What do you think that it are the most important thing for education? The teachers, the methods, the practice? What is the first thing in doing a good education?
Well, our experience has been that it's really that the teachers have to have, of course, the best knowledge, but the knowledge is not enough. It's really about being very interested in these topics and being inspirational as well, and let the students also to discover these exciting opportunities that circular economy provides. So I have seen a very, very inspirational ways of engaging with students, for example, so that they have been learning about circular economy in a very kind of a playful and gamification style as well. So I think it's really being clever also how to introduce these topics to students.
Mm-hmm. Okay, talking about Finland, Finland's an inspirational country for Romania. How can Finland help Romania to go up to the road of sustainability? How can you inspire us?
Well, that's of course a challenging question, as I haven't been in your country, so I don't know exactly how your society works, but I would think maybe kind of the starting point would be to evaluate the current state of play. For example, what is let's say that the basic situation of recycling, for example, is the possibility to invest in very, very good recycling systems? That's usually a starting point, and Finland is not in the top level there either, but it's certainly an area that I think is relevant, like a cornerstone for better circular economy. Circular economy is obviously more than recycling, as I mentioned earlier on. But the second thing I would say is really to invest into education so that the future generations are obviously working with these kind of topics. And the third one would be, of course, to invest in vocational education. Mm-hmm. So actually you get a better impact from that perspective. And inspire citizens. We have, for example, lifestyle tests for Finnish citizens, whether they are threat or opportunity for the environment. And it's done a million times in Finland, of population of 5.5 million people. So that gives an idea that citizens are very interested in topics. So if the citizens are on board, the rest will follow, in my opinion, in many ways. But at the same time, I have to say that it's also important to have very good governance. So leadership from the country top. If that exists and you have a very good strategies and implementation, it helps the citizens to make the right choice. Because you have to have the both. You have to have the grassroots activity, but at the same time, leadership from the top.
So you'll have the chance to understand better Romanian and Romanian authorities, because on 9th of June, you are going to have a online meeting with our governments on a circular economy. In the end, Kari, I would like to ask you to give a message for the Europa FM listeners and for our Green Mission listeners. What would you say?
Well, I would say that the social impacts of circular economy concern the whole society. And for your listeners, I would emphasize that the goal has to be an inclusive circular economy that is done and planned together with different stakeholders, regions, and especially with those who are affected the most of the change. And we all have a role to play in transition towards the circular economy. And companies, for example, can reflect if they could provide services instead of products and materials. And organizations play an important role in challenging societies to transition towards sustainability. And at the end of the day, and to conclude, each of us as individuals, we have a kind of possibility to choose who we vote for and what kind of choices we make in our everyday life. So I think that would conclude my message.
Kari Herleni, thank you very much.
Thank you very much.